Hi and welcome to this edition of Out of the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti Dream Machine. Now there are two models of the Dream Machine and the Dream Machine Pro. So the UDM and the UDM-Pro. We're looking at the Dream Machine today. This is the non-rack mountable version. Do check out one of our other videos that we've got the Dream Machine Pro. So what do you get in the box? Well, you get the unit itself, which we'll have a look at in a moment. You're going to get a get started guide. There you go. Not a lot of information, but basically the basics of how to plug it in. And you're going to get a power cord, probably two and a half meters long. Two-pin plug at this end because we're in Australia. And again, just a two-pin at that end. So what is the UDM? The Unifi Dream Machine. Can't even take those words, probably the Ubiquiti Dream Machine. All right, so this is it. It is a TARDIS, like a Doctor Who little TARDIS. All right, you get a little blue ring around the top when it's running. When you turn it on, it sounds a little bit like your doorbell chime, a little bit cheesy, but the unit itself is super popular because it is loaded with so many features. So let's go through what you get. Remember, this is the UDM. The UDM Pro has a slightly different spec setup because it's rack mountable. So in the UDM, you get a wireless access point. You get the equivalent of a Ubiquiti Nano HD, so a Wave 2 access point in the top of this. So great start for covering that first couple of rooms for where your router is. You get the Ubiquiti Cloud Key Generation 2 built into this. What is that? Do check out some of our other videos, but it is the management mechanism for looking after all of the Ubiquiti Unifi range, Unifi switches, Unifi access points. It allows you to do all the configuration without loading any software onto your computer or even using your smartphone. You also get the Unifi Gateway Security Appliance in here, the equivalent of the Ubiquiti USG. So you get a router built into this. It's going to give you some very basic intrusion prevention, but it's also going to give you control over the traffic that goes through your network. You also get a four-port switch. Here you go. And obviously your WAN interface there. But we'll cover those ports a little bit more in a moment. Key to note, these are not PoE powered. All right, so if you want to power some other access points, you do need either to use the PoE injector from the box that you get with your access point or chain this to another PoE switch. So let me show you the unit itself. Probably not a lot other than the logo there on the top to show you. Like I said, the access point's built in. All right, then on this side here, we have five ports. We have a four-port network switch and our WAN. All right, let's quickly talk about this. Like I said, it has a router built into it. It will do PPPoE. All right, so if you've got a broadband service that gives you Ethernet, so maybe you've got HFC or you've got fiber to the property, then this will plug directly into it. If you have fiber to the node, so your phone is, or so your connection is still provided over a physical phone line, then you will need a router to do bridging in front of it. You could maybe use a Draytech DV130 or something like that to do the route bridging, all right? And then you could send your PPPoE session from this device, which will pass it through your bridge, your little modem, out onto the VDSL network, all right? And that will allow all the IP addresses and everything to be available to this unit. But it is a full built-in router with a very basic firewall. It's venting there. It has a certain amount of venting on the bottom, and I believe it does have an inbuilt fan as well that allows some of the cooling to go on. So a fantastic unit if you're thinking of buying the USG, an access point and the cloud key. This is probably one of the best ways to go because you get that first access point built in. Then you can get a second or third access point, spread those out around your building, join them all back to here, and the cloud key in here will allow you to manage all of those in one go. So hopefully that's been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on wireless networking and firewall devices. We've got how-to guides on what do I need to run a Unifi network, where we talk about all of these components individually and how they actually fit together. So head on over and say subscribed, and hopefully that's been useful.